वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे इन सिविक्स चैप्टर नंबर 4 अर्बन लोकल गवर्नमेंट बॉडीज वी आर गोइंग टू सी. इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी हैव सीन अबाउट द लोकल गवर्नमेंट बॉडीज. नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल सी द अर्बन लोकल गवर्नमेंट बॉडीज. नाउ दे इंक्लूड द नगर पंचायत, द म्युनिसिपल काउंसिल एंड द म्युनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन. इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर इन द लोकल गवर्नमेंट बॉडीज वी हैव सीन द ग्राम पंचायत, द पंचायत समिति एंड द जिला परिषद. सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी द नगर पंचायत. इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीड द नेचर ऑफ लोकल गवर्नमेंट बॉडीज इन द रूरल एरियाज. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न something about the local government institution in the urban areas. This includes Nagar Panchayat, Municipal Council and Municipal Corporation. Now we will see first the Nagar Panchayat. Our country has a large number of towns and cities and they are growing rapidly. Villages are growing into towns, towns into cities and cities into metropolises. The rural area neighboring cities are also getting transformed. Now what are the facilities and problem in city? We will see. Now we will see what are the facilities first, what they provide. First they provide the opportunities for industry and business. Expanding service sector. Large scale opportunities for jobs. Availability of facility for entertainment, art and culture, etc. So all these are the facilities. Now we will see the problems. So what are the problems in the cities? They are the shortage of housing, insufficient space, traffic congestion, problem of disposal waste, increasing crime, a large proportion of population in slum areas. Now first we will see the Nagar Panchayat. The village that are in the process of becoming towns have a Nagar Panchayat. We see some area which are neither fully rural nor fully urban. In such areas the local government body is the Nagar Panchayat. Now some towns, some villages, they are neither the rural or nor fully the urban. So in that, in such areas the local government is the Nagar Panchayat. As the other local bodies, election to a Nagar Panchayat are held every 5 years. The elected members choose a president and a vice president from themselves. The president of municipal council is the chairman of all its meeting. Now here who is the president? Is the chairman of all its meeting. He controls the working of the council and keep a watch on financial administration of the council, means relating to the funds, money. In the absence of the president, the vice president look after the work of the council. Suppose for any work, if the president is absent, the vice president look after the work of the council. Now here, in the municipal council, there are some functions that are binding to the council. They are known as the obligatory functions. We will see. The municipal council. The municipal council is the form of the local government body for small cities. Where the small cities are there, the municipal council look after it. Election to the council are held every 5 years. The elected representative functions as corporators. Here corporator means what, student? Elected member of a municipal corporation. They choose a president from among themselves only. The president of the municipal council is controls the working of the council and keep a watch on the financial administration of the council. In the absence of president, the vice president look after the work of the council. There are some functions that are binding on the council. They are known as the obligatory functions. Here obligatory means what, students? Compulsory means legally. Now, what are the functions of this municipal council? We will see. They are known as, for example, lighting, street lighting, providing drinking water, public hygiene, sewage disposal, then registration of birth and death, etc. So, all these are the functions that the municipal council look through. Now, apart from these functions, the municipal council tries to provide additional facility to the people, and these functions are known as discretionary function. Here, student, discretionary function means what? Means donating or investment in the funds, planning new public roads and acquiring the necessary land, then improving the condition of slums, creating public gardens and parks, providing secure shelter for cattle are some of the discretionary functions of the municipal council. So, I had completed the 2 points of this chapter, that is Nagar Panchayat and Municipal Council. So, based on this, I will give one PDF. Write that in your civics notebook with neat and clean handwriting. Now, in this chapter also, student, some things are being deleted by the according to the rules of government. That also we are not going to take. Apart from everything, I am going to take. Okay. Thank you. Bye bye. Take care.